The Bible. Numbers chapter 15, verse 37. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, Speak unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make garments throughout their generations, and that they put upon the fringe of the borders a riband of blue. And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that you may look upon it, and remember all the commandments of the Lord, and do them. What was that blue that God told Moses to tell his people to put on their prayer shawls so that they would be reminded of the constant presence of God and the need to follow orders? The Bible does not actually say what that blue was. And over the years, there has been a lot of controversy about this. But many scientists today believe that the reference was to a certain type of mollusk, a snail called Murex trunculus. And from that snail could be processed a color. And that color, though, was purple. Well, no, it wasn't quite that easy. It took a lot of processing. But indeed, a purple color could be extracted from the snail. Most of this was done in Tyre, on the coast of what is now Lebanon, on the Mediterranean. And that city stank from the piles of snails. And the processing involved a lot of interesting chemistry, which, of course, they were not familiar with. But that purple, Tyrian purple, became very famous. In fact, it was very expensive to produce. You needed a lot of snails. It was so expensive that it was reserved for royalty. And indeed, the ancient Romans, only the emperor and the senators, the higher-ups in their society, were allowed to wear the Tyrian purple. But purple is not blue. So how do we come to blue from the purple and from this snail? Well, in 1980, an Israeli chemist by the name of Otto Elsner was experimenting with the snail. And indeed, he was able to produce the purple color, and that was no big secret. People were able to do that. But one day, he happened to do this right next to a window, and bright light came through the window. And he noticed something remarkable. That purple color changed to a beautiful blue. So from the purple came the blue. Today we understand what is going on. Ultraviolet light caused a breakage of bonds in the molecule. The original molecule that is responsible for the purple color is called dibromo indigo. Well, when ultraviolet light hits it, bromine atom comes off that molecule, and we get monobromo indigo. And if both bromines come off, we get indigo, the same indigo that is found in the indigo plant. So it turns out that when you process the snail under the right conditions, at first you get the purple, but if you expose it to ultraviolet light, you get this beautiful blue. And Baruch Sturman is a scientist in Israel who does this experiment, and you can go to workshops in order to see this done, and I had the fortune of going to one of those, and I produce these myself, the purple to the blue. So there it is. The consensus these days is that this is the blue that is referred to in the Bible. Now, of course, whether or not we put validity on exactly what the Bible says, that's a different story. I can't comment on that. I'm not a biblical scholar. But hopefully, with this discussion, you did learn a bit of chemistry of the difference between dibromo indigo, monobromo indigo, and indigo. And this is the color that today many scholars believe is the color of the tekelet, as it is referred to in the Bible, which is the blue color that was used to dye the fringes of the prayer shawl so that people would be reminded of the constant presence of God. So you learned something about the Bible, and hopefully a little bit of chemistry as well.